Would you be interested in a streamer that can do Bluetooth 5.0, Wi-Fi, AirPlay 2 and Multiroom all for under $100? Well then today is your lucky day because I found a Multiroom streamer that can do all of that for just $99 and on top of that even sounds great. Let me show you the WIM Mini Streamer. WIM Mini Streamer is a compact, round-shaped Wi-Fi multi-room streamer that retails for $99 and is absolutely packed with features. In the box you'll find the WIM Mini, a USB-A to USB-C cable, a stereo RCA to 3.5mm jack cable, a 3.5mm jack to jack cable and an optical Toslink cable. Looking at the shape, you can't help but see a resemblance with the discontinued Google Chromecast Audio. And although they are somewhat similar in functionality, the WIM Mini takes things to a whole new level. The list of options seems endless. First off, the WIM Mini supports AirPlay 2, Bluetooth 5.0 and up to 190 kHz 24-bit audio. Connectivity-wise, you can choose to output audio via 3.5mm jack or use the optical Toslink connection. The latter lets you bypass the internal Burr Brown DAC. Noteworthy is the fact that there's also an aux input. This gives you the option to connect other audio devices to the WIM Mini. Power is supplied via USB-C and connecting to your network is done via Wi-Fi only. Once connected, you can either play a wide range of music formats from your computer or NAS, such as MP3, AAC, ALEC, APE, FLAC, WAV, WMA, OGG and so on. Or connect to one of the many supported streaming services like Spotify Connect, Tidal Connect, iHeartRadio, Amazon Prime Music, Napster, Deezer and a lot more. To control the WIM Mini, you will have to install the WIM Home app for iOS or Android. Furthermore, the WIM Mini can also be voice controlled using Amazon Alexa or Apple Siri when connected over Wi-Fi to a voice-enabled device. Myself, I hardly ever use voice assistants, but I tried Siri with the help of a HomePod Mini and it works perfect. For my own use, I rather go with control apps. And the WIM Home app is very intuitive. It makes it super easy to get started with the WIM Mini and even set up a wireless multi-room system with other WIM Minis or with AirPlay 2 or Alexa-enabled devices. To test the sound quality and multi-room capabilities, I connected two WIM Minis to two separate setups. One in the living room that consists of a Denon AVRX 2600 with Eclipse Reference Premiere Atmos setup. And the second one I hooked up to my critical listening setup in my office room. Here I'm currently using a Bluesound Note as my main source, which gives me a good opportunity to do a direct comparison. The rest of my office setup contains a pair of DynAudio Lead 7 active monitors that are connected to an RME Audio 82 DAC FS that doubles as a preamp and a headphone amp. As I mentioned before, you can connect the WIM Mini either via the 3.5mm analog output or you can use the optical out. If you have the option to try out both in your setup, I recommend you do. In my living room setup, using the optical out did sound better compared to the analog output. The combination of the RME DAC and the DynAudio Lead monitor speakers is very neutral sounding. And always eager to expose any flaws in either a connected source device or a poor recording. I know that a setup like this may not be comparable to a typical and more forgiving living room stereo setup. It does, however, help me to find out just how good or bad the WIM Mini actually sounds. But before we get to the sound quality, let's have a look how to set up the WIM Mini. Installing the app is as easy as installing any app. When you're done, connect the WIM Mini to a power outlet and start the app. Allow the app access to your location and select your WIM Mini. Enter your password and make a network connection. The first time you make a connection, the WIM Mini will automatically update to the latest firmware. The next step is selecting the desired name for the WIM Mini that you're setting up. Since the first Wim Mini that I installed is in the living room, that is the name that I chose. After that, you can, if you want, link the Wim Mini to your Amazon account so you can control it with an Alexa device. The total setup time, including the update, took me less than 10 minutes, so that's not bad. Playing music from my NAS works responsive, and even though I have a lot of albums stored on my NAS, the Wim Mini app doesn't struggle too much scrolling through the whole list. Connecting to a music service is a breeze. Just select the service of your choice, for example Spotify, and select the Wim player in the app. That's all. For those on Apple's ecosystem, AirPlay 2 is built into the streamer. So you can send your music via your iPhone, iPad or other Apple devices to your speakers. And on top of that, Apple Music is supported as well. I have both Apple and Android devices, but I like Android a bit better. And the Android version of the Wim Home app is the one I've been using during my testing of the Wim Mini. You can also use the Wim Mini as a DLNA receiver and stream music from a compatible media server, like for example Olivana. Just start your server, select the Wim UPnP player that you want to send music to, and you're good to go. If you have multiple Wim Minis installed, you can easily set up a multi-room system. Just go to Devices and select the players that you want to use. The volume levels can be adjusted individually for each player, or you can choose to change the volume level on all selected devices simultaneously. It's not all good news though. During my 2 weeks of testing, I did experience occasional dropouts. However, since the Wim Mini only connects via Wi-Fi, that was to be expected. And I do live in a 6-person household in which everybody claims their piece of the online action. Whether you will experience dropouts as well depends on the quality of your wireless network and the amount of interference caused by your neighbor's Wi-Fi signals or other wireless gear. Now let's move on to the most important part. How does the Wim Mini sound? I honestly had no idea what to expect before I started listening, and I didn't really have any source device within the same price range to compare it to. My current streamer, the Bluesound Note, costs a lot more, and in direct comparison it is noticeable that the Note is more precise and resolves better in the high frequency range. Still, for a $99 streamer, I really cannot complain. For example, if I listen to Royals, sung by Lorde, it immediately becomes clear that the Wim Mini can handle itself surprisingly well. Lorde's voice is reproduced with clean, fine dynamics, and the powerful lows never get muddy. And after listening to more of my favorite high-quality recordings, I must admit that sound quality-wise, the Wim Mini exceeds my expectations. The Wim Mini is a very convincing offer. It has a near flawless operation and an excellent sound quality that punches way above my expectations. If you're in the market for an affordable, well-functioning and good-sounding streamer that can also expand to a multi-room setup, then I can highly recommend the Wim Mini.